Welcome, fellow adventurers. Today is the 125th day on the cruise, and we have come to Brisbane, Australia. Brisbane is a sophisticated and wonderful city with a cool climate and subtropical beaches. It has a fantastic cultural scene with more than 2 million residents. I only did a very short city tour because the family wanted to go to Steve Irwin's Australia Zoo. The zoo was about an hour's drive from Brisbane. It is the ultimate zoo experience with the crocodile hunter, Steve Irwin, as the passion behind this zoo. In fact, the highest attraction in the zoo was the famous croc show. The croc show was held in a huge arena with LCD screens where they started the show with a tribute to Steve Irwin, talking about his passion, his love for wildlife and conservation. I hardly think there was a dry eye in the auditorium by the time this was done. There were several trainers with the crocodile, and they had fed him and exercised the crocodile as well. They held the food out in such a way that the crocodile really had to exercise to get himself out of the water to get the food. Next stop was to the cassowaries. These are the third largest birds in the world. They are an endangered species with only about 1,000 of them left. They live in the wet tropics and support the rainforest biodiversity because mainly they eat fruit and they spread the seeds of these fruits all around. They are very colorful with a large bony area on the top of the head. Next, we saw the shingleback lizard. Their thick scales have earned them the name the pinecone lizard. Next, we saw the binturong. Many people call them bear cats, and they're neither bears nor cats. They're in the order of the Carvanera. They have these long whiskers that help them move debris out of the way as they're going through the treetops. They're a little bit on the shy side, and I found them to be very cute little animals. Talking about cute, there was the rhinoceros iguanas, and they were sitting head to head, embracing each other. It was so cute to see these iguanas. They are one of the largest iguanas in the world as well. You couldn't have a zoo in Australia without kangaroos, and boy, were there tons of kangaroos in huge areas. One of them was pregnant, where you could see the baby kangaroo moving around and the mother. And also there was a few joeys in the kangaroo sex. I can't help but get a little chuckle whenever I'm around the kangaroo because they are such different animals. And the way that they always use their hands and feet, they're like bent over all the time. It looks to me like they should be so uncomfortable. I also had a chance to see a kookaburra. I've remembered that song as a little girl. Kookaburra sits in the old gum tree,
counting all the monkeys he can see. Stop, kookaburra, stop, kookaburra.
That's not a monkey, that's me. Well, what I found out is when I went to Australia, they have what they call gum trees, which are very much like our eucalyptus trees. We had the best day ever hanging out with all of these animals. And it was very interesting. About 5 minutes before we were ready to depart, this huge rainstorm started. And we were very thankful that we got to see the whole zoo without the rain. As we left, we went back to the city and we were able to have a very short city tour where we could see different buildings. Everything from glass towers to old sandstone facades with the old and the new together. I really couldn't do Brisbane any justice as a city because we did spend almost all of the day at the zoo. But this city is so amazing. When I go back again, I am going to spend time there, and I highly recommend it. Our next stop is Sydney, Australia. In closing, my wish for you is that you will love abundantly, protect your health, and be adventurous for life. You are beautiful. Let your light shine. Aloha.